prediction can be summarized in one map. Now, this is the map of Delhi. The blue colors where the Aam Aadmi Party has won. The saffron colors where the BJP has won. The Delhi Assembly has 70 seats. Aam Aadmi Party 62. BJP 7. Congress for a second time in a row 0. Prime Minister Narendra Modi has congratulated the Aam Aadmi Party boss Arvind Kejriwal via tweet. He writes, "Congratulations to AAP and Shri Arvind Kejriwal ji for the victory in the Delhi Assembly elections, wishing them the very best in fulfilling the aspirations of the people of Delhi." Meanwhile, Arvind Kejriwal himself has summarized his victory in a few sentences. Flanked by his wife Sunita and his close aides in the Aam Aadmi Party, this is what the Delhi Chief Minister has to say.
दिल्ली के लोगों ने आज देश में एक नई किस्म की राजनीति को जन्म दिया है, एक नई राजनीति को जन्म दिया है जिसका नाम है काम की राजनीति। दिल्ली के लोगों ने अब संदेश दे दिया कि वोट उसी को जो स्कूल बनवाएगा। दिल्ली के लोगों ने संदेश दे दिया वोट उसी को जो मोहल्ला क्लिनिक बनवाएगा। दिल्ली के लोगों ने संदेश दे दिया वोट उसी को जो 24 घंटे बिजली देगा, वोट उसी को जो सस्ती बिजली देगा, घर घर को पानी देगा, हमारे मोहल्ले में सड़क बनवाएगा। दोस्तों, ये एक नई किस्म की राजनीति है, एक नई किस्म की राजनीति की आज शुरुआत हो रही है। ये देश के लिए बहुत शुभ चीज है।
In the next 1 hour on India Ahead, we're going to look ahead. Will the Kejriwal model of development now challenge the Modi model of development? What lessons should the BJP learn from its crushing defeat in Delhi? This is the party's sixth consecutive defeat in state elections now. And is the Congress party finished in Delhi? This is India Ahead at 9. I'm Jujhar Singh. Let's show you a quick collage of celebrations and reactions in Delhi today. We begin our big debate with a solid panel of guests in 1 minute.
गजब कर दिया आप लोगों ने।
उनको देशभक्ति माना जाता है, लोगों की सेवा करने को देशभक्ति माना जाता है, लोगों की शिक्षा पर, बच्चों की शिक्षा पर काम करना, लोगों की बिजली पानी शिक्षा स्वास्थ्य पर काम करना, इसको देशभक्ति माना जाता है। आज उसकी जीत का दिन।
उन्होंने संदेश दिया कि काम के नाम पे भी देश में चुनाव हो सकते हैं।
अमित शाह जी को और भाजपा को करंट लगाने का काम किया है।
केजरीवाल मॉडल ऑफ गवर्नेंस की जीत है।
आई लव यू।
Let's begin our big debate now. Chetan Sharma, editorial director, India Ahead, in the studio with me. Raman Malik, BJP's in Gurugram. Professor Ujjwal Chaudhary, political analyst in Kolkata. Sumit Peer, political analyst, is in Gurugram. Meetu Jain, senior journalist, is in Delhi. Amitabh Tiwari, political analyst, in the studio. And Gunja Kapoor, without her burqa, is in the studio with us as well. Let's have an open debate. Please feel free to come in whenever you like. But of course, don't talk over each other. Raman Malik from the BJP, the Aam Aadmi Party celebrating, but the liberals, the secularists, the communists, they're all very happy as well. They wanted your party defeated. What do you say to them?
Begani Shadi mein Abdullah Diwana.
Is that it?
What else would you like to, could you explain it? Is there any way to explain it? Those who have lost...
Although, you know, I don't...
Listen, those who have almost conceded around 60 seats, their security deposit. Congress would have lost their security deposit in almost 60 seats. They are overjoyed.
They just wanted you gone.
So that's okay.
They that's just why wanted I said, you
Begani
gone.
Shadi mein yeah. Begani Shadi mein Abdullah Diwana hota hai.
Although I don't know Chetan why the I don't know why the secularists are celebrating. Arvind Kejriwal is not Hindutva, but how is he secularist in the political context? He never supported Shaheen Bagh. He called it a distraction, which he would like cleared in a couple of hours.
He never visited Shaheen Bagh, Jamia, or JNU. He supports the BJP on
Article 370. The Aam Aadmi Party manifesto talks about Desh Bhakti curriculum. He recited the Hanuman Chalisa. Thank Lord Hanuman today for his victory. How's Arvind Kejriwal sitting a liberal, Chetan?
Well, I would say...
Just one minute.
Yeah.
I'm coming back to you.
And
yeah. I mean, it's not about being liberal. Yeah. It's not about being secular. Yeah. It's about having the appeal to the common man. Hmm. And I'll talk about a small incident. What was the most poignant scene that you saw on television today? The chief minister has a flying kiss to the electorate at large, saying, I love you, Delhi. Mm-hmm. Introducing his wife. To say it's his wife's birthday. These are all facets of a common man's leader. This is what appeals. This is that simplicity of that man that appeals in terms of posturing. Mm-hmm. It may be posturing, may be strategic, but it appeals. Mm-hmm. Secondly, you work. Let your work speak, not your words. Number three, when you may plan your work, but you've got to work your plan. So you don't just announce grandiose plans. You've got to ensure that there's work done and you have statistics to back that plan. Number four is at any stage of life, at any stage of a democracy, right? If you're able, and I think this is today when we say that India won, or when he says a new kind of victory has happened, I agree with him. Because this is a victory of development over divisiveness, of goods over God, of action against diversion. I think you've seen that all across the board, given the resounding nature of the victory.
So, I mean, Gunja, how do you look at it? Because just looking at the regular political pitch, you see Arvind Kejriwal, as I said, is not secular, he's not Hindutva, he's not leftist, he's not rightist, he's not upper caste, he's not identified with the scheduled caste. What is Arvind Kejriwal?
No, I don't think Arvind Kejriwal, I mean, just because he chooses to recite the Hanuman Chalisa doesn't make any Indian a less of a secular. Just because he's practicing his religion and he wears it on his sleeve, I don't think that's against the principles of secularism. However, the current liberal...
That's not how it should be, but that's how it's seen in the political context.
Yes, yes. So, of course, I mean, if you talk about liberals in today's context, they are just fundamentalists turned upside down. Because for them, as long as you are not towing their particular line, or if you're not really going and visiting Shaheen Bagh or opposing 370, you are not liberal enough. Mm-hmm. So, the problem lies with the definition of liberal in today's context. That said, of course, he's worn his caste identity on his sleeve. He said, I'm a baniya many times. He works like he's one of us, as Chetan sir said. And that's what we were discussing in the previous discussion as well, that, you know, he's learned this art to, you know, wear the victimhood on his sleeve every time he's shown as an
Less
underdog.
Now. Earlier he did. Yeah.
No,
yeah.
That's not.
Yeah, but I'm just trying to understand, Amitabh, what Chetan was saying a little bit earlier. What is the Kejriwal model? Can it be encapsulated in one word now, which is development? Is that the Kejriwal model now?
No. The Kejriwal's model is development, delivery of promises, and leadership. A leadership of a common man. He symbolizes the power of a common man. He has broken the barrier between politician and the common man, and he's shown the world or the Indian voter that a common man can take on the political class, form government, and also deliver on his promises.
You know, Sumit P, the Aam Aadmi Party's Raghav Chadda said today, this is a victory of Kejriwal model of development. Are we entering an era where it's going to be the Kejriwal model versus the Modi model?
I think, Jujhar, let's first understand AAP is an urban phenomena. The AAP's models and politics works in a cosmopolitan place like Delhi. When it go to a bigger state like UP, these all models fall flat. You know, that is what has happened to AAP in the past. The moment they try to leave Delhi, their all models fall flat. They don't work. You know, I love you, Delhi, and all is good.
But why should that be the case? What is AAP talking about? They're saying Bijli, Pani, schools, Mohalla Clinic.
They have a leader of opposition in Punjab. Is it only urban?
Yeah, it's purely urban. It will only work in a place like Delhi. We have seen there, though I congratulate AAP for a spectacular win today. Arvind ji and all the AAP cadre. But when you move out of Delhi, this kind of model does not work. Imagine a state like UP and you tell them, aapko bijli denge, metro denge, I will build bridge schools that every government has to do. You know, unfortunately, that bijli, pani, free thing or those,
so,
you know,
so what you're saying
really
it's a collective failure of the country that divisive politics works outside urban India. This is exactly what you're saying. And then we see that being pursued across by the BJP. Is that what you're saying?
No, I'm not saying that. I'm saying that this bijli, pani and these things might work very good in a state like Delhi. But when you move to bigger states, the problems are bigger. The kind and type of problems are bigger. First of all, Delhi has no farmers. Every other state, 70% of the vote is farmers. Then your landless labors, then your caste equations, then your so many things which
let
will
me assure
like
you
Delhi.
The basic problems remain for everybody. It appeals everybody. It's just that you have a far educated and a nuanced population in urban India who's able to raise their voice and relate to it, and less of all prey to any kind of semantic politics.
No, also Kejriwal does not have to take responsibility of a very critical variable called law and order.
Law and order.
And that's where I think a lot of politicians fail. Especially in your Hindi heartland, at least, most politicians end up paying for the lack of law and order.
But that adds to the point, then BJP should not oppose giving full statehood to Delhi.
I'm coming to Ramanji.
They should give the full statehood to Delhi.
That's the strategy that they don't want.
One second.
Go ahead. Yeah.
Okay. So, the first question that you were asking about the the statements of Mr. Kejriwal today on his winning. Agar humne kaha hota to bolte hamara character dila hai, hum communal hai. Agar wo kahe to theek hai. Dusri cheez, which is very important. Again, you are saying ki all of these issues that you were talking about that he did and what was his strategy, and it was pure mauke pe chauka. It was nothing else except that, yes, the credit must go.
We are talking about the Kejriwal model of development, which they are pitching
Malika, you saying that
versus the BJP model that which has been holding
sway. So you're
now
saying that it is just by fluke and by an opportunity that the AAP has come with 62 seats out of 70. Is that what you're saying?
Manish Sisodia very categorically said they support Shaheenbagh. They never go there. But they have the audacity to say, oh, we are nationalists. So
but remember, Arvind Kejriwal never said anything about Shaheen Bagh.
Yes!
Before you become great, you've got to be grateful. Before you become grateful, you've got to be graceful. At least be graceful in defeat.
Mauka and Chauka.
Meetu Jain is joining us.
They did it. I am saying that they did. We fought an election to win and we fought it hard and good. We have no regrets on it. The vote percentage
it is exactly because he's used a word that he lost the election, Mr. Malik.
But must understand something. You must understand something. A pro-incumbency vote is something where the seats increase, where the percentile increases. And I believe it that once the final results come, you will see the winning margins of all the candidates of Aam Aadmi Party who won has reduced, some may have increased. The seats have gone down, the vote percentile has not risen. So that is one another thing which must not be forgotten. Yes, we concede this, that they have again got a decisive mandate. Yes, they will do their part and we will do our part as opposition. But to outright...
So where did you go wrong? Mr. Malik, according to you?
Some fairy tale thing has happened, that's wrong.
Mr. Malik, where did you lose the plot? Where did you go wrong?
See, there are a lot of things to be assessed till, it's too early to assess all of those things. But yes, an 8% jump and still you have a transfer of vote. That is my internal, source-based gathering. How and the B team, how they perform. Those things are coming. We will do our introspection. That is not the case. We should be doing, we will do. We have won.
Ramanji, the loss for the BJP was substantial. Your vote share is 38% versus the AAP's 53%. Meetu Jain is joining us. Meetu, good to have you on the show. How would you look at this today?
Well, first of all, you know, I must really say I'm feeling sorry for the BJP and all the, you know, bucks around here, and for the comfort that they are drawing in the crumbs, you know, that their vote percentage has gone down. The percentage of votes where the Aam Aadmi Party is concerned, the victory margins are not going to be so huge. And also, one of the panelists also spoke of law and order. I mean, Jujar, the only thing I would not be doing on a show like this, on a day like this, is talking of law and order. Because remember, law and order in Delhi is with the central government, which is directly under Amit Shah. The same man who was on the street, you know, distributing pamphlets, going from house to house, trying to drum up support for his party, and for those people who were going around beating students in Jamia, beating students in JNU, and, you know...
One second, I think your audio seems to be breaking up a bit. Let's try and correct Meetu Jain's audio. We'll come back to you, Meetu, after that. But Ghanshyam Kaushik, spokesperson, Aam Aadmi Party, is now joining us. Ghanshyam ji, Arvind Kejriwal has been a success in Delhi, but your party's been a flop outside of Delhi so far. But I can see some signs today that you're already going to try and expand. Ek bahut bada hoarding aa gaya hai aapke party office ke bahar aaj. Usme likha hai, and I'm reading it in English, associate with AAP for nation building. Aap nation building ki baat kar rahe hain aap. Aap aapka aage ka fir matlab ye kya strategy bata raha hai Ghanshyam ji?
जी जुंजार जी, देखिए इसमें कोई बहुत बड़ा गणित नहीं है. हमने काम के ऊपर राजनीति की है दिल्ली के अंदर. हमने जो वोट मांगी, जो कैंपेन की, वो काम के ऊपर की. और मुझे लगता है कि जो असली राष्ट्र निर्माण है, जो देश की सेवा है, वो काम से होती है. अगर आप बच्चों को अच्छे स्कूल देंगे, अच्छी एजुकेशन देंगे, अच्छा मेडिकल सिस्टम देश के लोगों को देंगे, आगे बढ़ने का मौका देंगे, एक ऐसा माहौल देंगे जिसमें हर व्यक्ति अपनी प्रगति कर सके, तो मुझे लगता है यही असली राष्ट्रभक्ति है, यही राष्ट्र निर्माण है.
आप जीते
और
हैं
रही बात आपने
और एक
की
बड़ी कामयाबी
से बाहर जाके मैं वही जब
पर अब आगे जाके आप क्या करेंगे, क्योंकि ये संकेत आ रहे हैं कि आप देखिए आपके पार्टी के प्रवक्ता आज क्या कह रहे हैं. वो बात कर रहे हैं केजरीवाल मॉडल ऑफ डेवलपमेंट का, वो कह रहे हैं लेस एसोसिएट विद आप फॉर नेशन बिल्डिंग. बिहार की भी बात हो रही है, आम आदमी पार्टी इन बिहार.
हम वही बोल रहे हैं नेशन बिल्डिंग के लिए. नहीं नहीं, आप जो मतलब निकाल रहे हैं जुंजार, आप जो मतलब निकाल रहे हैं वो निकाल रहे हैं कि आप अपनी पार्टी को एक्सपेंड करेंगे बाहर. देखिए, पार्टी एक्सपेंड होती है उसमें शायद किसी को कोई आपत्ति नहीं होनी चाहिए. हमारा संगठन महाराष्ट्र में भी है, कर्नाटक में भी है, मध्य प्रदेश में भी है, छत्तीसगढ़ में भी है, हरियाणा में भी है, पंजाब में भी है. संगठन को आप बिल्ड किसी भी स्टेट के अंदर देश में कर सकते हैं. रही बात आपने कहा कि आप यहां से बाहर निकलकर चुनाव लड़ेंगे और अपनी फोर्स लगाएंगे, देखिए अरविंद केजरीवाल जी को जो बहुमत दिया है, जो मैंडेट दिया है दिल्ली के लोगों ने, वो बहुत बड़ा मैंडेट है. और अरविंद केजरीवाल जी डेडिकेटेडली दिल्ली के लिए काम करेंगे. पार्टी अगर चुनाव लड़ती है, जैसे कि अभी महाराष्ट्र में भी लड़ा था,
पार्टी आपत्ति है, आपको समझाऊं,
स्टेट यूनिट है, वो स्टेट यूनिट अपने तरीके से चुनाव लड़ सकती है, वो स्वतंत्र है. आप समझिए उसको, स्टेट यूनिट चुनाव लड़ने के लिए
नहीं,
किसी भी राज्य के अंदर
आपत्ति है. दिल्ली वासी होने के नाते आपत्ति है, आपको समझाता
हूं, के लोगों के लिए काम करेंगे
घनश्याम जी. नहीं, यही परेशानी यही है, ये आपत्ति दिल्ली वासी की तरफ से है कि आप पिछली बार भी आपने कोशिश की राइट कि आप नेशनल लेवल पे अपने आप को फैलाएं, वहीं पे आपने मात खाई. जब से आपने उस चीज को रोका, आपने एंटी मोदी स्लोगन रोके और दिल्ली पर फोकस करके काम किया, जमकर काम किया, अच्छा काम किया, उसका परिणाम आया. अब जो है ये अभी मन में आज भी भय है, अगर आप फिर से वो गलती दोहराएंगे तो फिर दिल्ली वालों का क्या हश्र होगा, ये सवाल है.
आप इसको, हाँ बिल्कुल, आप इसको मोड़कर मत देखिए, आप इसको ये देखिए कि दिल्ली के लोगों ने आज एक ऐसी राजनीति का समर्थन किया है जो काम की राजनीति है. हम उसी से देश को जोड़ना चाहते हैं. हम ये नहीं कह रहे कि हम बाहर निकलकर हमारी बहुत बड़ी इच्छाएं हैं पूरे देश में चुनाव लड़ेंगे, ऐसा कुछ नहीं है. हम देश के सभी अच्छे लोगों को ये कह रहे हैं कि देखो दिल्ली के लोगों ने कितनी बढ़िया राजनीति को समर्थन दिया है, आप भी अपने वहां पर लोगों को समझाएं और कहें कि इस तरह की राजनीति वहां भी स्थापित हो. मैं ये नहीं कहता कि वहां पर हम जाकर चुनाव लड़ रहे हैं, वहां जो भी इस तरह की राजनीति करता है आप उसका समर्थन अच्छा. कीजिए, आप उस राजनीति को समर्थन दीजिए जो दिल्ली के लोगों ने चूज की है, काम की राजनीति. और जो अरविंद केजरीवाल जी ने काम किया है 5 साल में, उसको जो दिल्ली के लोगों ने सपोर्ट किया है, और देखिए मैं बार बार ये बात कोट कर रहा हूँ,
उज्जवल चौधरी कुछ बोलना चाह रहे हैं मेरा ख्याल आपको,
केजरीवाल जी,
उज्जवल चौधरी जॉइनिंग अस, उज्जवल जी प्लीज गो अहेड, यस,
पांच साल दिल्ली के लोगों से जो वादे किए हैं वो पूरे करेंगे।
पॉलिटिकल पार्टी हैज थ्री रोल्स, गवर्नेंस, रिसोर्सेज एंड पॉलिटिक्स, आई मीन एक्सपेंशन ऑफ पॉलिटिक्स। गवर्नेंस, दिल्ली हैज गिवन द राइट टू केजरीवाल एंड टीम टू गवर्न इट फॉर द थर्ड टाइम. And this is not a right to an individual, it's to a political party led by an individual. So obviously, they should focus on that. That should be the priority number one. They have given 10 guarantees and there is a manifesto. So in my opinion, they should focus on that. But that does not stop it from acquiring more resources, human and otherwise, and expanding its politics. As has been told by this gentleman, the AAP spokesman, I also believe if there is an alternate politics of positivity, a politics of governance, politics based on Bijli Sadak Pani, Swastha Siksha and all that, why can't this bottoms-up welfare-dominated or welfare-centric politics be taken by AAP to other places? From a real political point of view, AAP has replaced...
You know, Ujjwal ji,
I'd like to understand. It's a very good point.
Many other states where there is a straight fight...
It's a great point, but let's be a little more practical. Let us try and understand, Ujjwal. You've been following politics, Ujjwal. You've been following politics for decades. Tell me which political party at a regional level is willing to adopt this. Tell me which of them have even shown the inclination to adopt this. Each and every, at least most of them, have only built up their castles out of divisive politics, not out of progressive politics. And I'm sure you'd agree with that.
So there is a new paradigm which has happened in Delhi just now, which is not technically divisive. And I appreciate your point, Chetan, when you said that AAP has grown and confidence when it stopped criticizing Modi. It's anti-Modiism. I appreciate that. So if you appreciate AAP's this particular stand, they can take a brand of positive and bottoms-up welfare-centric politics, which does not harp on neither the left nor the right and focuses only on welfare. It can go to other places. Now, historically, AAP has replaced Congress in Delhi. The same attempt it can do in Punjab. It is already the second most important party there. So it can do in Punjab. It can try to do at least in Gujarat, in Maharashtra, in Gujarat, in Madhya Pradesh, Chhattisgarh, Himachal and Uttarakhand. So Madhya Pradesh, wherever there is a direct fight between Congress and BJP. Having said this, whether the people accept or not, time will tell. If you ask me, I would suggest...
Yeah, but Ujjwal ji, I just want to ask you, because remember a few days ago, you were mentioning in our show that, look, if Arvind Kejriwal was to win this election thumpingly, which he has now, coupled with the fact that he has very good relationships with many opposition leaders like Mamata Banerjee, like M.K. Stalin, even the Shiv Sena is praising him now, that... maybe this Kejriwal model could become a challenge for the Modi model. Maybe Kejriwal might become some sort of a pivot for some coalition parties against Modi later on. What are you thinking? You know, what are your feelings on those lines now, today?
Appreciate. This is a time to look forward. And there is a common factor with many of these political parties you have named, whether it's Mamata, whether it's Kejriwal, whether it's Stalin, whether it's... YSR Reddy, there's a common factor, that's Prashant Kishore. There is a possibility that many of these regional political parties can come gradually together. And the Kejriwal model of harping on politics, you have already seen that Mamata Banerjee has gained much of the lost space of the Lok Sabha election. Last three by-elections have been hands down win for Trinamool Congress, much to the chagrin of the BJP. That is the reality.
Let's not forget a couple of things. This is a style of governance. You know, when there is an opposition, there's an opposition to a fact. The plank of development was started by the BJP themselves.
Yeah.
Right? So how are you going to oppose that? So you that's can say point. That you and understand this in the urban context where they don't have a history of performance over the last two decades. But across the other places... right, they've been fighting every single election by and large on the basis of development.
Agreed.
So to be able to oppose that under a different kind of development is not going to be easy. So perhaps you may see the opposition resorting to the divisive politics.
You have commented, let me finish in one line. In 2014, my columns and my social media posts were all in favor of Modi. All in favor of Modi, and I would like to make this point that that time I was angry on the policy paralysis of the UPA government and I was in favor of the Anna movement. And obviously, my posts were all in favor of Modi because of the language of development that he was speaking. But I did not know it will turn into love jihad, lynching, CAA and all that. That I did not know. This is the reality today.
So, you know, at some level, I think...
I need to fight on election.
And we have to appreciate one thing. You know, it's not as if when... It's not, you know, Jujhar, when the Modi government came to power, right? They seemed to have their heart in the right place. They talked about development. Somewhere down the line, if they lost the plot, right?
That's the point.
There would have been issues which enforced that. So it's not the same thing of when you run a state election and a national election. The compulsions are very different.
But
it's such a diverse country.
Yeah, but you know,
so obviously it requires horses for courses.
And it's an interesting point, Chetan. In fact, let me put that to Raman Malik from the BJP. Ramanji, you know, it appears that Arvind Kejriwal is the one who's learned the best lessons from the BJP. Yes. You see, Modi used to talk about Vikas. Now, Arvind Kejriwal is talking about Vikas. Modi used to use galis like Maut Ka Sudagar to his advantage. Arvind Kejriwal is using terrorists to his advantage now.
Yeah.
BJP used to say Lord Ram. Arvind Kejriwal is saying Lord Hanuman now. Kejriwal is learning Mr. Modi's lessons and beating you at that.
See, beating us, the BJP at what is a different issue, but as I said earlier, ki hum kahe to character dheela hai. Matlab, you say that if the same words were spoken after a victory by a BJP person, it would be said that it is communal. And if they say it is a normal statement, so that is the kind of dilemma that certain intellectuals.
My question is actually very different. Question is that all the things that Mr. Modi and the BJP used to come to power in 2014 and thereafter are the tricks, are the strategies that Kejriwal is now using and beating you at your game.
Jujhar, when you ask a question, at least be ready to listen to the entire point of view of the person answering. And yes, especially those who are probably at the receiving end of the day. So, the point is very clear. Yes, he has learned that
point. Acknowledged it.
But the fact remains
grudgingly.
That there is something which has been also exposed, and that is the way of politics that is being followed, and that is about opportunism. And what has happened here is, the classic example, as I was talking earlier, is the Shaheen Bagh issue, where one, the deputy chief minister says that, yes, we support it. The chief minister and the election juggernaut does not go there. And at the end of the day, they are talking something else on the policy. So that only shows that, yen ken prakaren, I am going to utilize whatever I can. And that is the opportunistic vulture politics that has been there as a trademark of Congress. But have they adopted that completely? That is to be seen, because I remember 2015 when Kejriwal won. Then Rahul Gandhi and Madam Sonia came out and they had given a statement where Rahul said, I am going to learn from Kejriwal and we are going to, you know, whatever. But at the end of the day, it so seems, with the ground reports and the feedback which has come to me, that apparently Abdullah got Diwana into somebody's barat. So that is what has happened. So the way Anand Sharma, the way others have gone ahead, the way Congress did a subtle press conference with Rajiv Singh Surjewala was indirectly saying that we are very happy that they have won. So the point is, if some political party is colluding with the other behind the scenes, and then they say, yes, we have won. Yes, congratulations, we have won.
You
I
know,
have
it,
no
it
problem.
Seems just the, it, just, it seems just the way the Congress, just the way the Congress couldn't get you out of the picture and at every state would attack you. You can't get Congress out of the picture. All you've done is attack the Congress, right?
No, no.
We've been talking about Arvind Kejriwal and his kind of a development model. What is it? Okay. What is it? What are the learnings that you have from Arvind Kejriwal? Let's understand that.
The first thing that I'm trying to point out, Chetan, here.
In fact, I'll just quickly interrupt for 5 seconds only, then you can answer both questions, which is that please remember, your party has lost 6 consecutive state elections in the last 15 months. Rajasthan, Madhya Pradesh, Chhattisgarh, Maharashtra, even though you were the biggest party there, Jharkhand, and now Delhi.
And Delhi 6 times.
See, both the pointers, one must understand, all that I was telling you was the fact of how there was a behind-the-curtain possible alliance. That is what I'm trying to expose. But having said that, yes, we have lost few elections. We have gained support also. And let me be very clear. We have no issues in losing elections. We have no issues whatsoever in losing elections.
What have been the learnings from this? What have been the learnings, Ramanji?
Jujar, please listen.
Complacency, arrogance. What have been the learnings?
We have no issues in losing elections.
But also late campaign.
We are not going to compromise with our stand.
That's not what your campaign says.
We are not going to compromise with the issues that we have lived with and we have fought for and we have stood with. So that is two. The third most important thing which has to be
It looks like you're not willing to either think about elaborate
or learning. Ghanshyam, I think, has a point. Ghanshyam.
Yeah. घनश्याम कौशिक आम आदमी पार्टी
जुंजार मैं काफी लोगों की बातें सुन रहा था और बीजेपी के भी हमारे साथी सो लेट मी पुट सम वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग पॉइंट द बीजेपी कैंडिडेट फ्रॉम मॉडल टाउन ट्वीटेड इन द मिडल ऑफ द कैंपेन की आई एम कोटिंग एंड अनकोट कोट एंड अनकोट ये लड़ाई भारत पाकिस्तान की है और 11 फरवरी को भारत जीतेगा पाकिस्तान हारेगा वी वर सेइंग दैट टाइम दैट इंडिया विल विन एंड नाउ वी आर सेइंग दैट इंडिया हैज वन क्या हमारे बीजेपी के जो साथी
के जो दूसरे मोटर पाव थे तेजिंदर पाल सिंह बग्गा वो भी हार गया आजहरी नगर से
कैसी भाषा यूज करते थे ये
आई एम नॉट अंडरस्टैंडिंग वन थिंग
पाकिस्तान की
बीजेपी हैज दिस नेशनलिस्ट पिच एंड ऑल ऑफ दैट मीतू जैन लेट मी कम बैक टू ऑन दिस यू नो द आम आदमी पार्टी क्लियरली आइडेंटिफाइड 3 or 4 डेवलपमेंट अचीवमेंट्स एंड गोल्स राइट स्कूल्स मोहल्ला क्लिनिक्स चीप वाटर एंड इलेक्ट्रिसिटी व्हाई डिड द बीजेपी थिंक दैट दे कुड ट्राई एंड विन अ दिल्ली इलेक्शन ओनली ऑन शाहीन बाग Why didn't they identify and market 3 or 4 development goals for Delhi as well?
Unfortunately, the only reporting that has been done is what we speak on Shaheen Bagh. It is not reported what we talk about.
One second. Let's give Neetu a chance. I'll come back to both of you.
No, just said Neetu. Neetu, please.
The part of speech where we talk about...
Ramanji, I'll come back to you. You're the star today. Yeah. 1 second. Neetu Jain, please.
You and the fact that the BJP was very, very clear when they said what these freebies are going to be budget, these freebies is not good, it's economy. So that was the plank of the BJP. I would like to just quote a few numbers for you. In 13-14, in the financial year, when the Aam Aadmi Party were in 14, facing a fiscal deficit of nearly 4,000 crore. In 17-18, the Aam Aadmi Party, Pani Sadak, free rail, free everything, had a fiscal surplus of 140 crore, right? Not just that, I mean, the fact is that where the central government is concerned, they made sure that they granted aid, as it is called, went down by some 600 crore or so. So, despite all that, the Aam Aadmi Party has done a fantastic job of providing what is called development politics. So, you know, the reason why the BJP today is so worried, and that should also be the same for other political parties who are, you know, listening to this show. This election was not about Shaheen Bagh. This election was about development politics versus, you know...
So, Delhi schools, madam, for your information, Delhi schools have a pass percentage of 81, whereas the K. Kendra Vidyalaya and the Dwar Shiksha Kendra, they have a percentage of 99.some%. So please tell me, how has the things been improving? How is the result improving?
Discuss the past 10 days.
That's a valid point. Had you talked about this, Raman Malik, and not about Pakistan and about Shaheen Bagh, perhaps you would have been better served.
Yeah, Kapil Mishra did a tweet about this.
If you had a problem, yeah, exactly. Yeah. What Amitabh is saying is right. Kapil Mishra did tweet about this as well.
See, the point is very clear. The point is very clear. You tell me something.
You won't get a chance.
You tell me something. When Amanatullah says and supports that fellow Imam, whatever his name was, why will a normal person of India, citizen of India, not say that with people who want to fulfill the dream of Break India Brigade, if a MLA of a party stands with those ideas, why would we not question? Any Indian would question. Anybody who has a little love for
Fair enough.
India
let Gunja. Gunja wants to respond to you. Gunja, go ahead. Respond.
Ramanji, there are two things. When you say that, you know, that Arvind Kejriwal did not speak about Shaheen Bagh and with voters, Sharjeel Imam did not, you know, drive a point home that he was an anti-national, etc., etc. The fact is that in Delhi, they have elected 7 MPs and they have, you know, ensured that the country is in the safe hands of the Home Minister. That's it. So now Delhi voted for its local issues. So, of course, Delhi does care about national issues and exactly why the way they voted in 2019, they've placed the country in safe hands of the Narendra Modi. That's it.
In fact, this was not about national issues. Sumit Peer, I think the BJP can take heart from the vote share also. 2015, they got 32% of the vote share in Delhi. Now they've got around 38%. You know, there's a vote in Dwarka who put it very aptly to a colleague of mine over here in the newsroom who said, Upar Modi, niche Kejriwal.
Yeah, you know, that was the sentiment.
And I think that's what Gunja is trying to echo as well. If, you know, I'm prepared to believe if there's a Lok Sabha election in the next few months, the BJP might sweep it again in Delhi.
Yeah. Exactly. So, Delhi is not going to trust its national security with Mr. Kejriwal even now. Yeah. They are very clear about it.
In fact, there was an opinion poll last week which said the Aam Aadmi Party would win, but if there's a Lok Sabha election, the BJP would sweep all seven seats.
But again, Jujar, all of us staying in Delhi have a problem, right? And we continue to have problems. That's because if you have this division of power, right? This problem is going to continue. We don't want this, right? Much as we may sanctify the fact that the BJP should be, you know, in the centre and AAP should be in the state, we still want a statehood for Delhi. So that it has a mandate of its own to perform fully. So, apart from Raman Malik, let's talk now to the AAP. Right? Let's talk to Ghanshyam. Ghanshyam, two questions which are very important. I mean, the future of Delhi lies with you at least for the next 5 years. Ghanshyam, can you hear me?
Point number one,
Ghanshyam. What is going to be your stance now for statehood of Delhi? How far are you going to go in pushing this? And point number two, how do you see Shaheen Bagh panning out in the next few hours?
We'll go away.
देखिए पहली चीज आपने पूछी कि दिल्ली से बाहर जाने के बारे में तो हम आगे कितना जाएंगे
मैंने ये नहीं पूछा मैंने दिल्ली के स्टेटहुड के बारे में पूछा उसके लिए अब आप क्या मशक्कत करेंगे
फुल स्टेटहुड ओके फुल स्टेटहुड यस ओके
जी
ठीक है फुल स्टेटहुड के मसले पर देखिए हम पहले ही इसका एक बिल पास करके विधानसभा से जो हम सरकार हमारी बनी थी हमने उसी साल एक बिल पास करके आगे भेज दिया था यानी आप जो यूटी का एक सिस्टम होता है उस यूटी के सिस्टम को आप समझते हैं यूनियन टेरिटरी में कि वो एलजी के पास जाता है और एलजी के बाद वो गृह मंत्रालय के पास होम मिनिस्ट्री के पास जाता है होम मिनिस्ट्री ने कुछ उसमें ऑब्जेक्शंस लगा के वो वापस भी भेज रहे हैं लेकिन हम लगातार उनसे फॉलोअप ले रहे हैं और अब उनके ऊपर डिपेंड करता है क्योंकि देखिए पूर्ण राज्य हम सिर्फ एक प्रस्ताव पास करके भेज सकते हैं हमारे हाथ में हमारी पावर में सिर्फ वही है जहां तक बात पूर्ण राज्य का दर्जा देने की
नहीं, आपके हाथ में तो हड़ताल भी है
करता है सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट
आप जब पावर में आए आपने एक मूवमेंट चलाया एक भ्रष्टाचार के खिलाफ एक मूवमेंट चलाया आप बहुत सी चीज कर सकते हैं सड़क पर भी आप काम कर सकते हैं अगर आप चाहते हैं अगर आप ये मानते हैं कि दिल्ली के बढ़ोतरी के लिए उसका उसका स्टेटहुड बहुत जरूरी है, तो आप इसे कहीं ना कहीं पालन कर सकते हैं। मैं ये पूछ रहा हूँ कि आप उसमें कितना विश्वास रखते हैं और उसके लिए कितनी मशक्कत करेंगे, ये मेरा सवाल है।
देखिए, इसमें हमें सेंटर कोऑर्डिनेशन की बहुत ज़रूरत पड़ेगी और हम जितने भी, मैं आपको दो तीन इम्पॉर्टेंट बिल गिनवा देता हूँ। एक पूर्ण राज्य का प्रस्ताव है, इसके अलावा एक स्वराज बिल है जो हमने पास करके भेजा हुआ है, इसके अलावा जो जिस भ्रष्टाचार के खिलाफ हमारी पूरी मुहिम शुरू हुई थी, तो वो एक बिल है जो हमने केंद्र सरकार के पास भेजा हुआ है लोकपाल का। तो हम चाहते हैं कि उन तीनों बिल के ऊपर, लोकपाल का भी, स्वराज भी और जो प्रस्ताव हमने पूर्ण राज्य के लिए भेजा हुआ है, उन तीन बिल के ऊपर, दो बिल और एक प्रस्ताव के ऊपर सेंटर अगर हमारे साथ सहयोग करेगा तो हम सेंटर के साथ हर वो चीज़ करने के लिए तैयार हैं, क्योंकि हम दिल्ली के लोगों के लिए काम करना चाहते हैं और दिल्ली के लोगों ने जो भरोसा हमारे ऊपर दिखाया है उस भरोसे के तहत हम सेंटर के साथ हर तरह का सहयोग करने के लिए तैयार हैं। हम आगे जा, देखिए हम उसमें क्या कर सकते हैं?
नहीं नहीं घनश्याम जी, कहीं ना आपकी नियत इन इश्यूज को लेकर साफ नहीं होती है। नहीं नहीं घनश्याम जी, मेरी बात सुन लीजिए, क्योंकि कहीं ना कहीं आपको ये एक्सक्यूज भी चाहिए होता है कि केंद्र सरकार हमको काम नहीं करने दे रही है, और वही विक्टिम हुड आप प्ले करते हैं, वही उसी विक्टिम हुड को आप गहना बना लेते हैं और फिर आप सड़क पे बिजली पानी और स्वास्थ्य की राजनीति करते हैं। यही हुआ है, आपने जितने भी बड़े मुद्दे थे उनको आपने 2 साल खूब सड़क पे धरने दिए और फिर आपने सोचा कि नहीं नहीं यहां से कुछ हो नहीं रहा है तो हमें काम करते हैं और इन बड़े इश्यूज को सेंटर पे थोप देते हैं कि भाई वो हमें काम नहीं कर रहे।
The same blame politics with the government.
Yeah, but on the issue of statehood of Delhi, by the way, if you remember last year, Lok Sabha campaign, it was the main plank of the Aam Aadmi Party for the Delhi Lok Sabha campaign. But it didn't work. So obviously they brushed it under the carpet because it's not resonating with the electorate.
No, but then on the same breath, Gujarat, when they go across and they say that because of lack of complete control, they have not been able to exercise authority and to develop the way they wanted to. A plank as well, so it's the same thing said in different words.
I think
Meetu Jain wanted to come in on this one. Yeah, me too.
So Jujhar, for somebody who politics,
jo ma'am ne baat ki hai wo dono alag alag cheez hai. Aapne kaha ki center kaam nahi karne deta, ye alag cheez hai, hum usme nahi ghusna chahte kyunki supreme court ka faisla jab
number 1, number 2, no state capital in the world has a, you know, I mean, we have the same situation as it was in D.C. is apart anything. All state capitals are can't have it under the and that's a political diplomatic necessity.
Meethi, your audio is not very clear. I think there appears to be a network issue of some sort.
I think Ghanshyam is responding. Ghanshyam, could you go ahead with your comment?
जी, जो मैडम ने बात की थी, वो दोनों अलग-अलग चीजें हैं। आपने मैम ने एक बात की कि काम नहीं करने देता सेंटर, तो देखिए वो चीज़ मुझे लगता है सुप्रीम कोर्ट के फैसले के बाद वो काफ़ी हद तक सेटल डाउन हुआ है, जहां सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने कैटेगोरिकली ये बताया है कि कौन कौन सी पावर सेंटर के पास हैं और कौन सी पावर दिल्ली सरकार के पास है। जैसे मैं एक एग्जाम्पल देता हूँ, CCTV की फाइल जब हमारे पास पावर नहीं थी, जब हर फाइल LG साहब के पास जाती थी, वो साइन करते थे, अप्रूव करते थे, तब वो चीज़ इंप्लीमेंट होती थी। तो कई बार क्या होता था, LG साहब अपने पास रखते थे और कहते थे कि मैं कर रहा हूँ, अभी एक हफ्ते में कर देता हूँ, 10 दिन में कर देता हूँ। तो वो चीज़ें हमें जाकर उनसे रिक्वेस्ट करके करना पड़ता था कि सर आप कर दीजिए, हम काम करना चाहते हैं, हम CCTV लगाना चाहते हैं, मोहल्ला क्लिनिक खोलना चाहते हैं। तो जब सुप्रीम कोर्ट के फैसले के बाद वो पावर दिल्ली चीफ मिनिस्टर के पास रह गई, अंतिम जो फैसला होगा वो दिल्ली के मुख्यमंत्री का होगा। तो मुझे लगता है बहुत सारे काम वहाँ से हमारे सॉल्व हुए हैं। जहाँ तक बात बिल की है, जो विधानसभा से पास होकर जाते हैं, उसमें जो रूल है वो अभी भी वही है कि वो बिल पहले LG साहब के पास जाएगा, फिर उसके बाद वो गृह मंत्रालय के पास जाएगा, क्योंकि ये यूनियन टेरिटरी है। तो उस बिल को अंतिम रूप गृह मंत्रालय के पास जाकर और फिर राष्ट्रपति के पास जाकर राष्ट्रपति के सिग्नेचर के साथ वो फाइनल हो जाता है। तो यहाँ जो बिल है या पूर्ण राज्य का दर्जा है, उसमें डिपेंडेंसी सेंटर के ऊपर है, क्योंकि वो रूल है, आपको ये समझना पड़ेगा। तो हम उनसे रिक्वेस्ट करेंगे, बात करेंगे।
घनश्याम जी, तो आप कहना क्या चाह रहे हैं कि जो सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने
हम वो करेंगे
स्पष्ट किया था कि सेंटर के ये पार है दिल्ली के ऊपर, दिल्ली सरकार का ये पार है, तो आप वो सुप्रीम कोर्ट का जो फैसला है, जो डिविजन उन्होंने किया है, वो आपको स्वीकार है और आपको अब स्टेटहुड, फुल स्टेटहुड नहीं चाहिए, कि अभी भी आप आंदोलन करेंगे फुल स्टेटहुड के लिए?
देखिए आंदोलन फुल स्टेटहुड के लिए जारी रहेगा, फैसला जो सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने दिया है वो अभी के कानून के तहत दिया है,
पर थोड़ा वीक तरीके से हमें लगता है,
उसके मुताबिक सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने फैसला दिया है। पार्लियामेंट इसको चेंज कर सकती है, पार्लियामेंट चेंज करेगी तो इसको फुल स्टेटहुड मिल सकता है। जो एनडीएमसी का एरिया है, न्यू दिल्ली म्युनिसिपल कॉर्पोरेशन का जो एरिया है, जहां पर हमारी एम्बेसीज और संसद और प्रधानमंत्री निवास है, मिनिस्टर्स रहते हैं, वो पूरा एरिया आप यूटी रख सकते हैं, बिल्कुल चंडीगढ़ की तरह, जैसे चंडीगढ़ को यूटी बनाया हुआ है, बाकी का एरिया पंचकुला का हरियाणा में आता है और मोहाली का पंजाब में जाता है, तो आसपास का जो रीजन है वो स्टेट में जाता है। तो हमने भी जो प्रस्ताव पास करके भेजा है फुल स्टेटहुड का, उसमें यही हमने मेंशन किया है कि आप एनडीएमसी एरिया को आप यूटी बना सकते हैं, लेकिन बाकी का जो पूरा रेडियस एरिया है उसको आप फुल स्टेटहुड देंगे तो हम दिल्ली को और बेहतर तरीके से चला पाएंगे अभी की व्यवस्था के मुकाबले।
चलिए हमारा सवाल ये था, आप इसको किस जुनून से और किस विश्वास से आप इसको फॉलो अप करेंगे। खैर आपका जवाब मिला, आधा जवाब मिला। अब हम इंडिया अहेड की बात करते हैं, यानी भविष्य की बात करते हैं। अब दिल्ली का भविष्य तो सामने नजर आता है हमको, बीजेपी का भी नजर आ गया जिस दिल्ली में, कांग्रेस का तो नजर ही आ गया। जो मैंने एक सवाल था ये बताइए कि शाहीन बाग का भविष्य क्या है।
बिल्कुल,
मुझसे पूछ रहे सर,
बताइए।
हाँ घनश्याम जी, आप ही से पूछ रहे हैं जी, सरकार आपकी है,
दिल्ली की बात तो आप ही से पूछेंगे।
देखिए शाहीन बाग का शाहीन बाग का जहां तक आपने सवाल पूछा है, शाहीन बाग में जो लोग बैठे हुए हैं उनका जो जिस किसी बिल पर संदेह है, किसी कानून पर संदेह है, तो वो मैं फिर आपको वो टेक्निकलिटी बात करूंगा, आप कहेंगे कि आप ये बात कर रहे हैं, वो कानून केंद्र सरकार ने बनाया है, उसमें दिल्ली
यही मैं बात कर रहा हूँ, इसलिए मैं बात कर रहा हूँ कि मुझे रोज बर रोज करोड़ों लोगों की आबादी के तौर पर जो है नुकसान उठाया जा रहा है, लोगों को दो दो घंटे लाइन में वेट करना पड़ता है, जो जगह वो पहले आधे घंटे में पहुंच रहे थे आज वो दो घंटे में पहुंचते हैं।
हमने भी ये बात रखी है,
ये दिल्ली वासी को परेशानी है, आप दिल्ली के सरकार चला रहे हैं, आप इसके लिए क्या करेंगे, ये सवाल है मेरा।
हाँ चेतन जी, हमने बिल्कुल इसके लिए आप जो पॉइंट रख रहे हैं कि वहाँ एक सड़क बंद है तो उससे वहाँ के रोजमर्रा के जो लोग वहाँ से जाते हैं, वो ट्रैवल करते हैं, उनको दिक्कत होती है, सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने भी यही बात कही थी, हम भी यही बात बोल रहे हैं कि गृहमंत्री साहब आपने वो बिल बनाया है, अगर कुछ लोगों के संदेह हैं वो वहाँ पर बैठे हुए हैं, हम ये मानते हैं कि कोई भी विरोध प्रदर्शन आप कर सकते हैं, संवैधानिक अधिकार है, लेकिन आप आम जनता को परेशानी में डालकर विरोध प्रदर्शन ना करें, हम ये रिक्वेस्ट सभी लोगों से करते हैं, और हम गृहमंत्री साहब से यही बात बोल रहे हैं कि आप प्लीज वहां जाइए, उनसे बात कीजिए, उनके जो संदेह हैं दूर कीजिए, क्योंकि सीए कानून आपने बनाया, हमने नहीं बनाया, हम उनके संदेह दूर कर ही नहीं सकते, हम उनके संदेह दूर कर ही नहीं सकते।
रमन मलिक बीजेपी,
सर आप ही दूर कर सकते हैं, आप
रमन मलिक बीजेपी
बात कीजिए, रोड
प्लीज पासिंग द बकल ऑन द यूनियन होम मिनिस्ट्री अंडर द बीजेपी,
पूरी तरह से सेंटर का सेंटर,
लेट्स आस्क यू द सेम क्वेश्चन रमन मलिक, व्हाट हैपेंस टू शाहीन बाग नाउ,
सर द यूनियन लॉ मिनिस्टर इज आल्सो इनोक्युलरली categorically stated to in a television program that he is ready to talk, he is ready to discuss everything, but it is not going to be in a manner ki ji nai ne gale pe us tarah rakha hua hai sahab ye kaam kariye, aisa thodi hota hai, a law has been made, if you have some problem please talk on the sections, which section is creating a problem for you, it is not about, it is
so what are you going to do now? Are you going to keep waiting for talks, offer dialogue again, or let it be, or forcibly close it down?
Allow the politics to subside, which means it will close down by itself.
Junjar ji,
I am very sure it will start because
Junjar ji, main ek baat kehna chahunga isme. Agar aap mujhe allow
kare. A lot of places were empty, and the best part is Junjar, the same people who say kagaz nahi dikhaunga are taking photographs with their voter ID cards. Why? वहाँ कागज दिखाते हुए दिक्कत है, यहाँ कागज दिखा के चमका रहे हो, क्या कहानी है साहब दोगलापन?
नहीं जुजार, can I make a quick point?
जुजार जी, मैं एक बात कहना चाहूंगा इसमें.
Yeah, quickly please, quickly. Yeah, yeah. We're running out of time. Quickly please.
जुजार, my point is that Mr. Kejriwal has won so many chief congress measures to him.
BJP
के congress measures to him. Now it is the moral responsibility of Mr. Kejriwal to go and talk and settle and let him mediate between the these protesters and the central government. At least he can do the part of mediation. If he cannot settle, can't even mediate. That is my point.
Right.
हमारी स्टेट के अंदर कुछ लोग बैठे हुए हैं, सड़क जाम है, हम आपसे रिक्वेस्ट करते हैं कि प्लीज आप उनके संदेह दूर करिए। लेकिन मुझे इसमें एक शिकायत है, अभी कुछ दिन पहले एक टेलीविजन चैनल पर इनके एक मंत्री जी हैं रविशंकर प्रसाद जी, उनसे सवाल पूछा गया कि भाई आपको अगर आपने वो कानून बनाया है, अगर कुछ लोगों को उसमें संदेह है, अगर कुछ शंका है उनकी, तो आप जाकर उनको समझा दीजिए। तो उन्होंने कहा कि भाई मैं क्यों जाऊं, हम क्यों जाएं, सरकार नहीं जाएगी, वे लोग उठकर आए हमारे पास, फिर हम उनको बताएंगे। सर आपको शर्म आती है उनके पास जाने में, वो आपके देश के लोग हैं।
उज्जवल चौधरी वांट टू से समथिंग ऑन दिस। उज्जवल जी वेरी क्विकली प्लीज।
आप प्रधानमंत्री हैं जिसकी आपकी सरकार है, आप उन लोगों को जाके समझा नहीं सकते? आपकी तो जिम्मेदारी
उज्जवल चौधरी ना
नागरिक है।
थ्री पीपल आर स्पीकिंग, हाउ कैन आई स्पीक?
Ramesh, I'm going to come back to you before we close. One second, Ujjwal Chaudhary wants to make a point.
Shaheen Bagh is a protest by men and women of various communities with a majority of Muslims against CAA law passed by the central parliament on the basis of the central government. So there has to be a discussion only with the government at the center. Point one, Kejriwal can mediate but cannot end it. Point three, if there is one road blocked by Shaheen Bagh, three other roads are blocked by the Delhi police. This is consciously done so that the hardship created is far more. And last point,
Professor Ujjwal Chaudhary, if that be the case, if there was no relation to Shaheen Bagh with the Delhi elections, you would have had a Shaheen Bagh in every single state of this country.
Yes,
why
yes.
was it only Delhi?
Exactly.
I think that's the point. That's the politics behind it is what pinches. And the Aam Aadmi, so to speak, is the one who suffers.
And not just that, Professor Chaudhary, journalists are being heckled openly. People sitting at Shaheen Bagh are not willing to communicate. They are not ready to talk. You have an elected MLA from the area. Can he take some responsibility to ensure there is a dialogue? Those people are willing to listen.
My point is not that. My point is it has to be stopped. It has to be
resolved. That will continue.
And resolution can come from the central government. That's my point.
Okay.
Ghanshyam ji, what we expect from you is just the way you have gone to the LG with a plea for statehood and get your work done. We request you to do the same thing right now to ensure that this entire imbroglio in Shaheen Bagh is put to rest immediately.
And your MLA from Okhla, where Shaheen
Bagh is. Can you try and show that to us?
Your MLA over there, Amanatullah Khan, appears to have the confidence of the Shaheen Bagh crowd, by the way. Oh, yeah. Maybe he could be one of the interlocutors.
I can understand your point.
50,000 more votes, Rajar, this time.
बिल्कुल मैं समझता हूं आपकी बात।
50,000
और खान हमारे वहां से
लेट घनश्याम रिस्पॉन्ड।
वो मीडिएशन करने के लिए तैयार हैं। वो हाँ बिल्कुल, उसमें हमें कोई गुरेज नहीं है सर। हमारे विधायक है वहां से, वो विधायक बात करने के लिए तैयार हैं और उन लोगों से भी बात करने के लिए तैयार हैं। लेकिन ये केंद्र सरकार से कोई बात तो करे, वो तो आना ही नहीं चाहते। वो कहते हैं जी हमारे पास उठकर आए लोग तब हम जवाब देंगे। जी इतना अहंकार ठीक नहीं है।
आप
आपके देश के लोग हैं, आप उनसे बात कीजिए। हमारे विधायक तैयार है बात कराने के लिए। हमारे विधायक तैयार हैं। मैं अमानतुल्लाह से बात
क्या केजरीवाल साहब कल जाएंगे शाहीन बाग सरकार से?
आप उनके रिप्रेजेंटेटिव केंद्र सरकार
केजरीवाल साहब कल जाएंगे शाहीन बाग? शाहीन बाग दिल्ली का एक हिस्सा है, उनकी सल्तनत का एक हिस्सा है। क्या वो जाएंगे उनके
शाहीन बाग पे? केजरीवाल जी अपने जाने का जवाब खुद देंगे। लेकिन जहां तक मेरा सवाल है, आपने मुझसे पूछा है, मैं पार्टी की तरफ से, हमारे एक वहां विधायक हैं, मैं उन विधायक से बात करूंगा कि वो मीडिएशन करने के लिए तैयार हो जाए और हम केंद्र सरकार से बात करेंगे। केंद्र सरकार से कोई भी रिप्रेजेंटेटिव
बहुत कृपा होगी
वहां जाए और उस बिल के बारे में समझा दें, क्योंकि बिल वो हमने बनाया नहीं, हम समझा नहीं सकते उसको। अगर मैं आपको कहता हूं
ऑलराइट ठीक है, जल्दी से
हमें पता ही नहीं।
आई एम फीलिंग अ बिट गिल्टी। वन सेकंड लेट्स जस्ट क्विकली मूव ऑन बिकॉज़ वी हैव जस्ट गॉट अबाउट 3 or 4 मिनट्स लेफ्ट। वन सेकंड रमन जी, आई एम गोना कम बैक टू यू, डोंट वरी रमन जी। We have not even asked one question to do with the Congress. One question only on the Congress, Ujjwal Chaudhary. They are down to just 4% vote share in Delhi. I was reading a commentator who said that whenever the Congress has gone below 20% vote share in any state, it's never recovered. Example, Andhra Pradesh, Odisha, the Northeast. Can the Congress ever recover in Delhi now?
Very tough. At this point of time, Congress has lost, neither has strategy nor has leadership. And this time, Congress has 9% vote has come down to 4. And this 5% has gone to BJP, by the way, because Aam Aadmi Party has got the same. So Congress is, at this point of time, their politics can change in 10 years. But at this point of time, Congress has no hope. And Congress should actually tie up with powerful regional parties. If it is very serious in combating BJP in future, tie up with powerful regional parties in every state. And that is one point. And on the other hand, Aam Aadmi Party would also make an attempt to dislodge Congress wherever Congress is the main opposition party of BJP in the other states. This is the future going ahead now.
All right. In the last 3 minutes now, let's go around the table, 20 seconds to everybody, and figure out that the next 5 years, what do we want from the Aam Aadmi Party government in Delhi? Your final thoughts, what you want them to do in Delhi the next 5 years? Let's begin with Chetan.
Statehood of Delhi. I think there has to be complete power in the hands of the Chief Minister, because then there's no blame game. That one single thing can dramatically change this, the capital. And we all should fight for that, whatever it be.
Amitabh.
Big mandate brings big responsibility. AAP should try to develop Delhi as a model state and then spreads its wings in the other parts of the country.
Gunja Kapoor.
Three things. One, clean air. Second, adequate pricing of utilities. We don't want, I mean, at least I don't think freebies is sustainable. And third thing, I really, really hope Kejriwal will not go back to his dharna politics.
Sumit Peer.
I think three things, Jishar Bhai. First thing is, please, Shaheen Bagh se mukti dilaiye. Point number two, no pollution in Delhi. Point number three, women safety. These are my three.
Meetu Jain, you've traveled and covered Delhi a lot. What do you want from the Aam Aadmi Party government now?
I want them to win the MPD election, number one, and get and clear Delhi of the garbage, which is the responsibility of the BJP, which is at the moment in power in the MCD.
All right, Raman Malik, besides wanting the BJP to come back in the next 5 years, what would you like to see in these next few years?
See, I would like that Yamuna is clean. The dues for Haryana on the waterfront are paid back. And jhoot should not be the only plank. And one more thing which I would say to the Aam Aadmi Party is, tu jaha jaha chalega, mera saaya saath hoga. We will play the hardest opposition that you will face for a constructive Delhi.
All right, Ujjwal Chaudhary, you are now in Kolkata, but you're a frequent flyer to Delhi. How would you like Delhi changed in the next 5 years?
Women's security that can only be assured by giving police to the state government. Without that, women's security is the responsibility of the center under which police comes. So statehood and women's security, point one. Pollution, both of Yamuna and this and the air. But that is also dependent on the stubble burning of UP, Haryana and Punjab. So it has to be a combined effort of four governments together. And the last 10 guarantees that Kejriwal promised before the election, take those 10 guarantees in war footing as early as possible.
Ghanshyamji from the Aam Aadmi Party, you have a lot to reply to, but before that, let me put my two or three points forward as well. One, like Ujjwalji was just saying, please fix the air pollution. I know you've got to do it along with the center. Number two, fix the Yamuna pollution. That also you've got to work with the center. Number three, which is completely in your domain, transport. When Sheila Dixit left as chief minister over here, there were 9,000 buses in Delhi. Today, there are 4,000 buses in Delhi. So let's give the final word to you, Ghanshyamji from the Aam Aadmi Party.
बिल्कुल आपने बहुत सही मुद्दे उठाए हैं और हम इन सभी मुद्दों के ऊपर काम करेंगे दिल्ली की जनता ने जो हमें मैंडेट दिया है इतना बड़ा मैंडेट उसको सर आंखों पे रखते हुए हम अगले 5 साल दिल्ली के लोगों के लिए जितने भी वादे हमने उनसे किए हैं वो सब पूरी मेहनत से, पूरी लगन से, पूरी ईमानदारी से पूरे करेंगे और 5 साल के बाद एक बार फिर से अपना रिपोर्ट कार्ड लेकर सामने आएंगे और बताएंगे कि हमने आपको जो वादे किए थे वो हमने आपको डिलीवर क्या किए हैं।
All right, it's very interesting.
Good way to end, yeah. You know, Delhi aapki hai, lekin Delhi hamari bhi hai. And we also have our rights. Thank you very much.
You know, it's very interesting. Delhi 9 months ago in the Lok Sabha election said Modi. Now Delhi in the assembly election is saying Kejriwal. It seems the message of Delhi is upar Modi, niche Kejriwal. Thank you very much to all our guests for joining us. Thank you very much for watching as well. Bye-bye.